Get ready to match the star. Avery Schreiber. Brett Sommer. Gary Berghoff. Phyllis Newman. Richard Dawson. Thank you, Richard. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74.
And thank you, friend. Got them all riled up, eh, John? What'd you do to them? Anything special today? Now, save some, because you got a long ways to go here.
I have a couple of newies for you.
That's right. All us old folks on the block, that's all the celebrities here who've been here before, will warmly greet the two new celebrities,
yes.
Avery Schreiber and Phyllis Newman.
Yes.
How
yes.
delighted we are to have you with us. I'll tell you how we greet.
Yeah, I've seen your act before. I know how you greet.
You do know how we
yes,
greet. Okay, Avery, I'll show you how we do it here, too. I've never worked with you. I've worked with Phyllis before, and she's a delightful lady, but you're a very talented guy also, and I've never worked with you before, and it's a pleasure to have you here.
It's good to be here.
Thank you. That's not so funny so far, is it?
That's because you didn't kiss him. It's only funny when you kiss.
Now, let's welcome our two civilians, Fred Mills and Carol Holmes. Hello there. Fred is our current champion. He has won $8,000. And he's wearing a snappy-looking suit. He's a snappy kid, isn't he? Good-looking guy. What are you doing after... No, that's him. And Carol Holmes is challenging him, and we've played one round, and the score at this moment is 5-1 in favor of the challenger. And you got some doing to do there, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, we'll do it right after this message for you. Are you ready? Okay, I'm ready. I'll push this button, reveal our second round questions, and ask Carol to make a selection.
I'll stay with A.
A it is. Now, there's only one person playing, and that is Avery Schreiber.
Oh!
What?
And that's yes. a true thing he said.
Is this my life?
This
what do you
is
mean?
Just for you, dear. Now, here's what happened. The first round was played yesterday when you were not here. And everyone matched Carol except the person who was sitting in this position who was pretty dumb.
Phyllis, you just heard Phyllis just laughed.
I don't remember who it was. No,
she just went totally
no,
blank.
It wasn't. It was just one of those things. So this is only for you. Ready?
Okay.
Baron von Frankenstein said... Antipasto. I said, since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a blank.
You must have been really stupid, whoever.
It was a different question yesterday.
Oh,
you have to do something. You write what you think is. Since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a blank. Think about that while he's writing his... Then you put the card in the slot, Avery.
I put the card...
Yes.
I'm here to help you. Think of me
my
as a helper.
My own
Don't think
All right,
of me as
Carol
your
Holmes.
Enemy.
Baron von Frankenstein said, since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a...
Heart.
A heart. Okay. She understood the question very well, Avery. Did you understand the question?
Yes, I did.
And what did you write?
A heart.
Heart! You did indeed understand it. Well done, old bean. Now, see, now that you've matched her, it says don't write.
Oh.
Okay, just do what we tell you to and shut up.
They ought to have a sign up there that says,
All right. Okay, now, Fred,
Don't
you've got to match five celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Everyone plays...
Except...
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Okay. This is for
everyone. I'm glad she's not playing.
This is for... This is for everyone except Beulah Witch.
Trouble is, when she's not playing, she still sits here.
Now, here we go. Now, this is very important for Fred, so listen carefully, if you would. On Christmas Eve, When Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys for the toys and discovered two of his elves blanking in the sack. One more time.
Say it again.
On Christmas Eve, when Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys and discovered two of his elves blanking in the sack.
The audience has got it.
I'm not writing, so I can look.
Oh. But you may be a telepathist.
Got the idea?
Yes, I do.
No, she got the idea,
Avery. If they only knew what Dawson threw away.
You got the idea?
Constantly. I got the idea.
All right.
Do you? Huh?
Yes.
He writes,
I agree with you, Gary.
Very slowly, doesn't he?
Yes, you're a very slow writer. Can you write a little faster?
It's done.
Yeah, now put it in the slot there.
I'll put it in the slot.
I know they told you to write big, but okay, there it is. Fred Mills. On Christmas Eve, when Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys and discovered two of his elves blanking in the sack.
Kissing.
Yay! Yay! Do elves do that too?
What do you think stunted their growth? No wonder you don't have any children.
Match everybody, Fred. Let's go. You need five kisses. Go, Avery.
It's very interesting because Avery means king of the elves.
It does.
Yes. No one knows that.
In what language?
In English.
Oh, in English. Avery, king of the elves.
Which understand Avery. English. Oh. Okay. Sleeping.
Congratulations. You got $100. You stand by for a moment while we say goodbye to Fred Mills, who will be leaving here with a smile on his face and a song in his heart because he has won a total of $8,000. There's a little message for you. We'll be right back. Here we go with Carol Holmes, who hasn't been up here before, have you?
Nope.
Why are you standing so far away from me?
Oh, well.
Oh, thank you. She's a very quick study, isn't she? Now, Carol, the way this works is, first you stand close to me, like this. No.
And you get the money without answering, right?
We polled a recent studio audience, Carol, and we got their best response to this. Blank stone. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500. Bing. If you match it. You're a little slow with the binger there, fellas. If you match the next one, you get two. Oh, wait, now you're a little fast with the binger there. Now, wait, don't bing until I tell you to bing. All right, then if you match the bottom one, you get 100. Bing. Oh, boy. Is Gus on the binger? Oh, we got a new binger, that's why. Where's Gus today? He's on sabbatical. He's what? Oh, Deidre's on. Oh, we got a lady binger today? I never had a lady binger before in this show, though. Anyway, three celebrities are allowed to give you a little help. Whom do you choose?
Richard, please.
The Blarney Stone.
The Blarney Stone. There's one.
Phyllis.
Gem.
Gemstone. Yay! There are two.
One person.
Yeah. Avery.
Birthstone.
Okay, Avery. So you got Birthstone, Gemstone, and Blarney Stone. Now you can take one of those, Carol, or if you don't like any of them, you think you got a better one, give us that. What do you want to do?
I thought of something else, but, Rolling Stone.
You think Rolling Stone would be a good choice?
Yeah!
Well, you know, that didn't occur to me, but now that you say it, I think it's not a bad idea. All right, Rolling Stone, she's on her own. She rejected the celebrity suggestions. She's chosen
Very
the
wise.
Rolling Stone.
You made a good choice.
And if you sink alone.
I know.
We're not going down with you there.
Awesome.
Captain is not going down with the boat this time.
I feel guilty.
Oh, well, that's a very sweet thought. Let's find out if Rolling Stone is up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Tombstone.
The was an older group.
To strike a cheery note.
An old bunch was here that day. Now, let's find out if Rolling Stone is under the $250 response. Birthstone. Where's the one? That's the one Avery gave you. Okay. Last chance for Rolling Stone. Audience, you touted her on this now. You're going to get it if it's not under there.
You're going to be sorry.
Last chance, the $500 response. You're right. I don't know. This is a very unusual audience, John. I could tell just as soon as I walked out that there was something different about them. They're smarter than the ones we usually get. Okay. Well, Carol, you got the $500. Now you play for a 10 times that amount or $5,000. But before you can collect, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be exact. Which one will it be?
I'll try Richard.
You'll try Richard.
Well, sure. I gave it Blarney Stone. Yes. You, why wouldn't you choose me?
And here is the $5,000 question.
Blank. Blank.
No, not blank. It's blank Jones. J-O-N-E-S. Blank Jones. Finished. Now, we need an answer from you, which you think will match Richard Dawson's answer. What do you say? Blank Jones.
Tom Jones.
Tom Jones?
That was my first thought.
Is that your first thought?
Yeah.
Okay, Richard, for $5,000, she says Tom Jones will match you. What do you say?
Well, it's your own fault, because I said Blarney. You can Blarney? See that I'm not...
Barnaby Jones? The girl?
No, the girl who was in the Addams Family. Carolyn Jones.
Oh, Carolyn. Oh, yeah.
Well, her middle name's Tom.
Charlene, would you, if you would, please? Well, she's very happy, and she's very excited.
Oh, look, she's crying.
You realize that we're still on camera? You don't know. All I said was... Oh! That girl... I want to tell you something. That girl blushes easier than any person I've ever known in my life. And she is probably so red now, it's unbelievable. She thought we were in the commercial, and I just said, throw me the box of Kleenex, because poor Carol here had shed a tear over her good fortune. There's a souvenir card for you. Well, listen now, you're gonna pull yourself together and meet another player. You gotta play another game. It's time to do that right now. So let's welcome Reed Montgomery. Reed, you know Weepy Carol Holmes, do you?
Yeah.
She's shedding tears of joy there. Tell us a Reed Montgomery story, if you would, please.
It's kind of a flop, but I'm from Birmingham, Alabama.
Yes.
And I've got twin little girls that are 5 months old, and I'm married.
Yes.
And, I have another little girl that's 4 years old. I'm a brick mason.
You're a what?
Brick mason.
A brick mason.
Uh-huh.
That's quite a skill. Yeah. May I see your hands? Turn them around. Yes, you're a hard-working fella. Yes, he's got calluses on his hands. He's a hard-working fella.
Gene?
Well, listen, yes.
I want to see a really hard-working pair of hands.
Oh, that's
a
good one. Well, good luck to you, Reed.
I picked up three dishes
You ready to
today.
Have a go at it? Yeah. Okay, I'll push this button, reveal our first round questions, ask you to make a selection.
A, please.
A it is. New game, everybody plays. Everybody knows that Tony Bennett sang a certain song. And because backstage, and when we're goofing around all the time, he does a marvelous imitation of Tony Bennett.
That remains to be seen, sir.
Just do that one phrase. Everybody knows that Tony Bennett sang...
I left my heart in San Francisco.
Absolutely.
I didn't know Sonny Tufts could sing.
But nobody knows that Brett sang.
I left.
Well, that's Jack, honey.
I left my blank in San Diego.
All right, there it is. Everybody knows that Tony Bennett sang, I left my heart in San Francisco. Nobody knows that Brett sang, I left my blank in San Diego. Go, do something with that. With
I've
dispatch.
Already
with expedition.
Right.
I left my.
I left my blank
in San Diego. Across the bay. Hello, Reed. Everyone knows that Tony Bennett sang, I left my heart in San Francisco, but nobody knows that Brett sang, I left my blank in San Diego.
Well, she wears one, I guess, her bra.
Her bra?
She doesn't even wear what goes in a bra. Are you kidding?
How would he know?
I don't know.
You know what he's done? He's bored a hole through the wall.
Oh, he's fixing room is next door to yours,
yes.
Isn't it? I see. All right.
I knew I saw Blink. Well, I thought it was the CBS.
But it was only
probably him.
It was only to let the scent out. Right?
All right, here we go. He says, I left my bra in San Diego. Now, what do you say, Avery?
Well, I wish I could have said that. I thought that was very funny.
Yes.
But no, what I thought was that she left her car in San Diego.
Don't hurt yourself. He's banging his head on the floor there. All right, sit down and get it all together. Okay, Brett, what do you say? This is your moment.
I say, what am I doing on this show next to this madman, is what I say.
What
no, I said I left my mate.
My
in
mate
San
in San Francisco.
Francisco.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, we've always heard. All right, Gary, bra's the answer that he's looking for.
That is the dumbest answer I've heard in the many
really?
Weeks that I've done this show.
Yeah. I'll go to blank.
Go to bra.
It's ridiculous. You're always talking about it. You know, yes. Lonely lady here. She left her husband there.
All right, two of one there. How about you, little girl?
Well, I don't want you to think that this is a new show called Get Brett, but I said she's going to kill me. She left her brains.
There's nothing wrong with that?
You know, I never liked Phyllis Newman's laugh.
I was just trying to match. It wasn't a personal thing.
Nothing personal.
I thought that everybody would have thought that.
Keep giggling, honey.
He says, but nobody knows that Brett's saying, I left my bra in San Diego is what he says. What do you say?
She left her wig there.
Left her wig. Everybody knows she wears a wig. You might not have known that there. What about you, Patty?
What about me?
What about you, I say?
I said that she left her jack in San Diego.
Left her jack in San Diego. All right, so none for you. Your question coming up right now, this for you. All right, here we go with the second half of round one. You ready, Carol?
Ready.
Here, let's see how you do with your first round question. Tarzan said to boy, let me teach you. Let me teach you first law of jungle. Never buy blank from man who wear plaid suit.
Please say that again in English.
Tarzan said to boy, let me teach you first law of jungle. Never buy blank from man who wear plaid suit.
Do you realize that if I came from a rich family, I wouldn't have to answer that question?
That's right. Write something there. I'm
all
just
right.
Doing that to kill time while you're finishing your thing there.
That's the
Brett's ready. They're all ready.
They're
down
all
here.
Ready.
Patty, are you ready?
No.
Remember, you went to college. Come on now.
Yeah,
you remember how to write words and all that. All right, you got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Carol.
Wait a minute.
She's drawing pictures.
Don't
ask
here.
That. Come on.
Don't
embellish
you,
it
please.
Then.
People here waiting to go home.
Tarzan said to boy, let me teach you first law of jungle. Never buy blank for man who wear plaid suit.
All I can think of is clothes.
clothes. It's going to be one of those pitcher's duels again.
The audience come on.
Let me see it, Avery.
All righty. Monkey, I'm sorry, babe.
Never buy a monkey
this woman's heart.
From a man who wear plaid suit. Okay, Brett, go.
Oh, well, why not? I said vines.
Vines. All right.
You missed the whole point, man.
Well, did you get the point? Tell him what it is, Gare.
I wish you'd get a play in New
York,
honey.
Would you buy a... Well, you shut up.
Come on, let's go.
Would you buy a used elephant from this man?
Buy a used elephant. There you go. All right.
Listen, mine is good. I want you to consider this.
Yeah.
A used loincloth. That's
close. A used loincloth. Yeah,
right. Okay.
Right. Okay. All right, close. There it is. Go.
I want to hear a ding. There's another ding.
That's two for you. How about you, Patty?
No dings.
No dings?
No, I don't know where I was. I said never buy magazines.
Never buy magazines. Okay, so at the end of round one, 2-0, favor the champ. Now this message for you. Thanks. Just a word of thanks to you and to you for joining us. Bye-bye. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production.
Friends, our current champion has won $8,000. And he's wearing a snappy-looking suit. He's a snappy kid, isn't he? Good-looking guy. What are you doing after... No, that's him. Carol Holmes is challenging him, and we've played one round, and the score at this moment is 5-1 in favor of the challenger. And you got some doing to do there, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, we'll do it right after this message for you. Are you ready? Okay, I'm ready. I'll push this button, reveal our second round questions, and ask Carol to make a selection.
I'll stay with A.
A it is. Now, there's only one person playing, and that is Avery Schreiber.
Oh!
What?
And that's a true thing he said.
Is this my life?
This
what do you
is
mean?
Just for you, dear. Now, here's what happened. The first round was played yesterday when you were not here, and everyone matched Carol except the person who was sitting in this position, who was pretty dumb.
Phyllis, you just heard Phyllis just left.
I don't remember who it was.
She just went totally blank.
No, it wasn't. It was just one of those things. So this is only for you. Ready?
Okay.
Baron von Frankenstein said,
oh, dialect.
Antipasto. I said, since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a blank.
He must have been really stupid, whoever.
That was a different question yesterday.
Oh,
you have to do something. You write what you think deserved it. Since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a blank. Think about that while he's writing his... Then you put the card in the slot, Avery.
I put the card...
Yes.
I'm here to help you think of me as
my
a
own
helper.
Spot.
Don't
All right, Carol
enemy.
Holmes. Baron von Frankenstein said, since today is Valentine's Day, I'm going to give my monster a...
Heart.
A heart. Okay. Now, she understood the question very well, Avery. Did you understand the question?
Yes, I did.
And what did you write?
A heart.
Heart. You did. Well done, now, see, now that you've matched her, it says don't write.
Oh.
Okay, just do what we tell you to and shut up.
They ought to have a sign up there that says don't worry.
All right. Okay, now, Fred,
don't
you've got to match 5 celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Everyone plays...
Except.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Okay. This is for
everyone. I'm glad she's not playing.
This is for this is for everyone except Beulah Witch.
The trouble is, when she's not playing, she still sits here.
Now, here we go. Now, this is very important for Fred, so listen carefully, if you would. On Christmas Eve, when Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys for the toys and discovered 2 of his elves blanking in the sack. One more time.
Say it again.
On Christmas Eve, when Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys and discovered two of his elves blanking in the sack.
Get ready to match the star. Avery Schreiber. Brett Sommer. Gary Berghoff. Phyllis Newman. Richard Dawson. Thank you, Richard. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
And thank you, friend. Got them all riled up, eh, John? What'd you do to them? Anything special today? Now, save some, because you got a long ways to go here.
I have a couple of newies for you.
That's right. All us old folks on the block, that's all the celebrities here who've been here before, will warmly greet the two new celebrities,
yes.
Avery Schreiber and Phyllis Newman.
Yes.
How
yeah.
delighted we are to have you with us. Tell you how we greet.
Yeah, I've seen your act before. I know how you greet.
You do know how we
yes,
greet. Okay, Avery, I'll show you how we do it here, too. I've never worked with you. I've worked with Phyllis before, and she's a delightful lady, but you're a very talented guy also, and I've never worked with you before, and it's a pleasure to have you here.
It's good to be here.
Thank you. That's not so funny so far, is it?
That's because you didn't kiss him. It's only funny when you kiss.
Now let's welcome our two civilians, Fred Mills and Carol Holmes. Hello there.
The audience has got it.
I'm not writing, so I can look.
Oh. But you may be a telepathist.
Got the idea?
Yes, I do.
Oh, she got the idea,
Avery.
If they
only knew what Dawson threw away.
You got the idea?
Constantly.
I got the idea.
All right.
Do you? Huh?
Yes.
He writes
I agree with
very
you, Gary.
Slowly, doesn't he?
Yes, you're a very slow writer. Can you write a little faster?
It's done.
Now put it in the slot there.
I'll put it in the slot.
I know they told you to write big, but okay, there it is. Fred Mills. On Christmas Eve, when Santa got to the very first house, he reached into the sack of toys and discovered two of his elves blanking in the sack.
Kissing.
Yay! Yay! Do elves do that too?
That's how they get little elves.
Well, that's how they get little elves.
What do you think stunted their growth?
I didn't know that.
No wonder you don't have any children.
Match everybody, Fred. Let's go. You need five kisses. Go, Avery.
It's very interesting because Avery means king of the elves.
It does.
Yes. No one knows that.
In what language?
In English.
Oh, in English. Avery, king of the elves.
Which understand Avery. English. Oh. Okay. Sleeping.
Oh. Congratulations. You got $100. You stand by for a moment while we say goodbye to Fred Mills, who will be leaving here with a smile on his face and a song in his heart because he has won a total of $8,000. There's a little message for you. We'll be right back. Here we go with Carol Holmes, who hasn't been up here before, have you?
Nope.
Why are you standing so far away from me?
Oh,
well. Oh, thank you. She's a very quick study, isn't she? Now, Carol, the way this works is, first you stand close to me, like this. No.
And you get the money without answering, right?
We polled a recent studio audience, Carol, and we got their best response to this. Blank stone. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500. Bing. If you match it. You're a little slow with the binger there, fellas. If you match the next one, you get two. Oh, wait, now you're a little fast with the binger there. Now, wait, don't bing until I tell you to bing. All right, then if you match the bottom one, you get 100. Bing. Oh, boy. Is Gus on the binger? Oh, we got a new binger, that's why. Where's Gus today? He's on sabbatical. That's,
He's what?
Oh, Deidre's on. Oh, we got a lady binger today? I never had a lady binger before in this show, though. Anyway, three celebrities are allowed to give you a little help. Whom do you choose?
Richard, please.
The Blarney Stone.
The Blarney Stone. There's one.
Phyllis.
Phyllis.
Gem.
Gemstone. Yay! There are two. One.